Okay, I
Yes,
have
sir.
written
Okay.
some. You want to give once again, Safwan?
So
या
already
कल
done.
वक्त? ऑलरेडी डन. अच्छा, दोबारा नहीं करना. ओके फाइन. ओके, आई हैव रिटन मरियम. यू हैव आल्सो डन. समायरा इज आल्सो डन.
Sir, yesterday you said you were just brushing up the topic and not actually
You
taking
want to
viva.
you want to give viva today also?
No, sir.
नो no? अच्छा, जो हो गया हो गया, उसी को रहने दे. लॉक कर दे उसको. यस्टरडे इज वाइवा.
Sir, all my answers were wrong yesterday.
योर आंसर्स वर नॉट रॉन्ग, ओनली
Okay,
वन ऑफ
sir.
देम वॉज रॉन्ग.
So, okay, sir. Then
फर्स्ट
lock it.
ओके, आई आस्क थ्री क्वेश्चंस एंड टू ऑफ देम वर राइट. ओके, टू ऑफ देम. प्लीज, न्यूज़पेपर रीडिंग है ना? न्यूज़पेपर रीडिंग
Yes, sir.
ऑलवेज. चलो, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. सो प्लीज राइट. फर्स्ट थिंग, व्हाट इज हाइब्रिडाइजेशन? ओके, व्हाट इज हाइब्रिडाइजेशन? So hybridization is what? It is mixing of atomic orbital. Okay, it is what you will remember. This is not something that you will write. Okay, so it is, I say in Hindi, it is chutney theory. Okay, it is chutney theory. Why? This is mixing of atomic orbitals. Mixing of atomic orbitals. Now, if I want to write the detailed definition, so please write with me the process of mixing of two or more atomic orbitals of atomic orbitals of one atom. Okay, of one atom. That means A will have some different atomic orbitals, and A ki atomic orbitals, they will be taking part in the mixing. Okay, they will be taking part in the hybridization of one atom having equal, or rather equal is not a very good word, same or slightly different energies or slightly different energies to form new set of orbitals, to form new set of orbitals which is equivalent in shape, energy, it's equivalent in shape, energy and size. Shape, energy, and size. It's called hybridization. It's called hybridization. Okay. Now, here, what we will have, the hybridization, it is obtained by how? By the mixing of atomic orbitals or two or more atomic orbitals. Okay, mixing of two or more atomic orbitals to form hybrid orbitals. Two or more atomic orbitals mix to form new hybrid orbitals. The new orbitals that are formed, they are known as hybrid orbitals. They are known as hybrid orbitals. Okay. Now, after hybrid orbitals, so for example, if you have S and P mixing, okay, we are having what? S and P, which are mixing, okay. For example, S and P mix to form SP. Okay, there's a new orbital which is known as SP. There will be a new orbital which will be known as SP. for example, if you have S, comma P and P, there are two P's mix to form. Now this new orbital will be known as SP2. The new orbital will be known as SP2. Similarly, you can have S, comma P, comma P and P, three P will mix to form SP3. Okay, to form SP3. Now if you have D, so on you can answer, so on you can write for SP3, then you can also have SP 3D, then you can also have SP 3D2, okay, SP3, D2, etc. Please write this down. Let me know if you're done.
Done, sir.
All of you are done. Safwan?
Done, sir.
Done. Okay. Now, please write. The new orbitals form. Are known as, they are known as hybrid orbitals. Or hybridized. Or hybridized orbitals. Okay, they are known as hybrid orbitals or hybridized orbitals. Now, one more point which is very important is the how many hybrid orbital will be formed. Okay. How many hybrid orbital will be formed? So please write now in a note type of thing, characteristic of, please write characteristic of hybridization. Characteristics of hybridization. Characteristics of hybridization. So in the first point, you will write number of hybrid orbitals. I will resemble it as HO. Okay, HO. Number of hybrid orbitals is equal to number of atomic orbitals that are mixed. That are mixed. Okay, number of hybrid orbitals is equal to that are mixed. And mixed is not the right word exactly. That are hybridized is the word. If you are having subjective examination, you will write which are hybridized. Okay, but hybridization is nothing but it is mixing. So I call it atomic orbitals that are mixed. Second point, the new hybrid orbitals that are formed. These orbitals, they are equivalent in energy and shape. Okay, equivalent in energy, shape and size. The new HO formed are equivalent in energy, shape and size. Okay, they are equivalent in energy, shape and size. Third point is hybrid orbital are more effective in formation of bond. In formation of bonds. The fourth point is, this is very important, hybrid orbitals are directed in space. Directed in space in such a way, that the repulsion is minimum. Repulsion is minimum. And repulsion is minimum and distance is maximum. Distance is maximum. Why do they do that? They do that to get a stabler repeat. To get a stable arrangement. To get a stable arrangement.
Done, sir.
Done. Next slide, conditions for hybridization. Conditions for hybridization. Conditions for hybridization. The first thing is that in bonding, which take place, valence shell electron, they are participating in bonding. That is why only the valence shell orbitals participate in the hybridization. First point is only valence shell orbitals participate in hybridization. Participate in hybridization. Second point, the difference in energy between the atomic or the atomic orbitals which are taking participating there, which are participating, that should be small. It should not be very high. If it is equal, that is fine. It should not be very high. Okay, difference in energy, difference in energy of atomic orbitals getting mixed they should be small should be small third point promotion of electron we will see what is promotion promotion of electron is not a necessary condition this is not a necessary condition Fourth, half filled orbitals is not a necessary condition. Half filled orbital is not a necessary condition. Okay. So these are the conditions. I will be referring to conditions and the characteristics of hybridization. But before that, I will write some note which you have to always take what, okay? Which you have to always take care of.
Done, sir.
Done, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Where is Hishma? Hishma is not coming today. Right? Note. This is very important. First point. The first point is that only the atomic orbitals of central atom take part in hybridization okay wo ek atom ka hota hai hybridization okay please never forget this point okay only hybridization is of only one atom okay in a molecule only one atom will be getting hybridized and whatever mixing will be taking place it will be for one atom phenomena second point only sigma bonds are formed only sigma bonds are formed by hybrid orbitals they can only form sigma bonds okay and no and not pi bond that also and not pi bond and not pi bonds last point one of the lobes gets enlarged after hybridization after hybridization okay all of you are done just let me know
done sir
okay now there is one more topic which is Wesper theory okay you must have heard Wesper theory have you heard Wesper theory
yes sir
Yes, no, you have heard the whisper theory. Achha, it has postulates, yes or no? Postulate likhaya hoga aap logo ke school mein, postulates of whisper theory, no? Yes or no? Don't remember. If you don't remember, tell me, do you don't remember?
Don't remember, sir.
You don't remember, okay, fine. See, so the topic I will be here also teaching, whisper theory also, okay? Whisper theory also, because it is somewhat related. It is not completely related, but it is somewhat related. Saath mein karenge, jaldi ho jayega. Okay? And it is also, alag-alag padhane se dikkat hi hoti hai. So first of all, we will see what are the postulates for whisper theory. Okay? What are the postulates for whisper theory? Now, you don't need anyone. You don't need anyone. It is a theory and people thought about the atoms. People thought about the atoms. Okay? And how the bonding is taking place. What are the electrons which are taking part in the bonding? So the first question that I will ask you, Mariam, you will answer me. There are two types of electron in a particular shell. There are valence electron and there are pore shell electrons. Yes? Valence shell. So what do you think? Which will be taking part in the bond formation?
Sir, valence electron and?
There are core electrons, na, jo valence ke andar hota hai.
Yes, sir.
Core shell. So which will be taking part in bond formation? The valence shell or the other ones?
The valence shell.
The valence shell, right? The valence shell electron, they will be taking part in the bond formation. Okay, fine. Now you will tell me if I want to have some bonding, then there should be attraction between the two molecules. There should be attraction between the two atoms which are bonding. But both of those atoms, they have valence shell electrons in them, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now let us suppose A and B, and we are just looking at A, and A has some valence shell electron. So what do you think when the bonding is taking place, the pairs of electron, they will repel each other, right? The pairs, yes, of electron, sir. Right? Now when the repulsion will be there, what a system will do? Repulsion, nobody likes repulsion. So they will adjust the electrons in such a way that the repulsion is minimum. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And if the repulsion should be minimum, that means you have to have maximum distance between them. That is possible. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us suppose valence shell electron to hai. Now we have to also give some shape to that valence shell. Hai na? How should be the atom looking? How should be the valence shell? What do you think? Should we keep the shape as triangle? No, not triangle, na? Because triangle 2D. So we have to think about 3D shapes. Yes or no? We cannot have 2D shapes.
Yes, sir.
Because the real world is 3D. Now in 3D, choose one of the solids. Choose one solid that you think will truly represent an atom.
Diamond.
Diamond. You're talking as of, I'm talking about one atom. If you look at one atom, what shape it will have? Okay, for example, if you see a room, okay, Mariam, your room.
Yes, sir.
What shape it is? Your room is?
Cube.
Haan, usi hisab se pata hai na? So those terms.
Cuboid.
Atom will be cuboid. Okay, any other options? Cube. Okay, Samaira, what do you think? Atoms, if you look at atoms.
Same, sir. Cuboid maybe.
Cube or cuboid maybe. Safwan, what do you think? How will the atom look? Safwan is not here or what?
There you are, sir. There you
are. Haan ji, sir. Bataiye tab.
Pata nahi, sir.
Pata nahi. Achha. Think about the first introduction of atoms that you have seen in class 10. The shells, the valence shell. So all of those shapes, what was the shape of those things? The shell and valence shell in 10th standard, the initial introduction. What was the shape in the notebook, in the copy, in the textbook? Yes, Mariam. How was the shape? How did you draw the shells? Yes, Mariam.
Circle.
Circle, na? Now extend circle to 3D. What will you get?
Sphere.
Sphere, exactly. Now, do you think sphere is a bit better than cube?
Yes, sir.
Right, Mariam, do you and sorry, Samaira, you agree?
Yes, sir.
Anna, so sphere. Okay, what we will say? We will say that the valence shell will be taken as a sphere, and those electrons, now they will be on the surface. Can we say that those electrons, can we put those electrons in the surface?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now the electrons have all these sphere surface area. Okay, the spherical surface area is present, and then the electron, it can be anywhere, and it should be somewhere where the repulsion is minimum, distance is larger. Okay, distance is larger. Okay, now what you have to do, you have NCERT textbook, Mariam and Safwan and Samaira.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, open the NCERT textbook and go to page number 130. Go to page number 130. Are you there, Mariam and Samaira? Yes. Now read the statement, the main postulates of Vesper theory. The first statement. Yes, Mariam, can you read it loud?
The shape of a molecule depends upon the number of valence shell electron pairs, bonded or not bonded, around the central atom. Two pairs of electrons in the valence shell repel one another since their electron clouds are negatively charged. These pairs of electrons tend to occupy such positions in space that minimize repulsion and thus maximum distance between them.
Wait. You guys are getting this postulate, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now you are getting it? Okay. Now, obviously, you have to think about it first. Okay. So I didn't write anything. I just made you think that, so jo atom kaisa hoga? Electron hoga, so they will repel each other. Now, when they will repel each other, and obviously, central atom is the one that will be... Central atom is the one that will be determining the shape of the atom, because surrounding atom uske saath lage hue hain, right? So it is holding many surrounding atoms. That is why it is the core, central, and it will be determining what? It will be determining the shape. Now, in that central atom, the bonding is taking place with the valence shell electron. That is why the valence shell electrons are those which are determining the shape of the molecule. Okay, so what we have to do here in Vesper theory, hybridization, all these thing mixture, they will be telling you about the shape of the molecule. Okay. Shape of the molecule. Now let us come. So Vesper theory, I'm leaving some parts. There are two more points. That is, the multiple bond is treated as if it is a single bond, single electron pair. The two or three electron pairs of a multiple bond are treated as a single super pair. Then there is regarding some resonance structures. So those two points I will be covering. Okay, those two points I will be covering. But till the point valence shell is taken as a sphere where the electron pair localize on the spherical surface at maximum distance from one another, till there you can perfectly understand. Now let us look at that point of multiple bond. Okay. Now what is that point saying? You don't have to write this. Okay, please don't write this. Just listen. You remember we made carbon dioxide. We initially made it like this, correct? And after that we asked different oxygen atoms and carbon atoms. सर बताइए आपको इलेक्ट्रॉन की जरूरत है क्या? देन कार्बन सेड आई नीड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, देन वी गिव इलेक्ट्रॉन्स लाइक दिस, करेक्ट?
यस सर.
सो नाउ सी द शेप फॉर दिस एंड शेप फॉर दिस इज सेम ओनली, करेक्ट? इफ आई सी, प्लीज रिमेंबर, इफ यू सी द रियल एटम, ना इफ यू सी द रियल एटम, वहां कार्बन सी नहीं लिखा रहता. ओके, इफ यू हैव वुड इट हैज कार्बन, तो सी नहीं लिखा रहता. देयर विल बी सम स्फेरिकल ऑब्जेक्ट देयर. ओके, सो लेट मी रिप्रेजेंट द स्फेरिकल ऑब्जेक्ट, this black point, acha, and then let me also represent this oxygen as red. Okay, this oxygen as red, and this oxygen also as red. Okay, and they will also not be very far away, they will be very, okay. Oh, I have a software, I can show you CO2. Wait a second. So what I am trying to say is that whether you have one bond or double bond between two atoms, they have the same structure only. Okay, they have the same structure only. Okay, so that is why the double bond and triple bond, they are treated as a super pair of electrons. This is a single pair of electron, this is a single pair of electron, this is the super pair of electron. Okay, so let me just show you the okay, so I have this software which I use for preparation of molecules. Okay, so if I will click here, na, it will give you CH4. Okay, this is CH4. Can you see this? Let me zoom in a bit. Okay. So again, this is again just a model. This is just again a model. Okay. Now what I will be doing, I will be clearing this hydrogens. Okay, I will be deleting this hydrogens because I don't need this hydrogen. Deleted this, and then I will add oxygen to it. I will add oxygen. So one oxygen is there, and I have to wait a second. I have to adjust hydrogen. Hydrogen bond should not be adjusted. No, not adjust hydrogen, oxygen only. So one oxygen is there, and one oxygen will be here. And then I will make a double bond. So see, this is the single bond. It is the same shape. If I add the double bond, it is again the same shape, correct?
Yes, sir.
That is why whether you have a single bond, double bond, or triple bond, they are treated same. They are treated in a similar way. Fine. So you will leave around half a sheet of page for Vesper theory. Okay, you will write VSEPR theory. You will write VSEPR theory, and you will leave page. VSEPR theory. And you will leave some page, okay? And one point that you should always remember is that the atom, it is spherical in shape, okay? It is a spherical in shape. So this is your circle. I can make the sphere by just adding this two type of lines, and it may give you the illusion that it is spherical, okay? This is one point that you have to remember. And here is the nucleus of that atom, okay? This is the valence shell, and this is, for example, here are the electrons like this, okay? Here will be the electrons. If you have all the eight electrons, so this will be the arrangement, maximum distance, okay, maximum distance, right? So I'm just moving on. And you have to write the topic which is known as steric number. Please write down steric number. Wait a second, this is steric, I think it is RIC only. Steric number, okay. So steric number is not explicitly mentioned in NCERT, but it is very useful for Vesper theory, hybridization, and etc. Okay, so it is very important. Why? And it is very easy also. Steric number is what? Steric number is equal to number of sigma bonds. Number of sigma bonds plus number of lone pairs. I'm not saying non-bonded electron, I'm saying pairs, okay? Number of sigma bonds plus number of lone pair. You can also say number of, like if the number of sigma bond is two, that means there will be two surrounding atoms. So number of surrounding atoms, you can also say number of surrounding atoms plus number of lone pair. Okay, steric number, also one point, steric number is defined for only central atom. Okay, steric number is only defined for central atom. That means we will be calculating the steric number for central atoms. Please let me know if you are done.
Done, sir.
Okay. Fine. So we will start with, we want to find what? We want to find the shape of different molecules. Okay, shape of different molecules. So I am asking you a few points first. Suppose you have a molecule. You have to find the shape of molecule. You have a molecule which has only one atom A. Okay, which has only one atom A. Do we have to find its shape? Tell me yes or no. Like ek molecule. Okay, in that molecule there is only one atom. So what will be the shape? There will be no shape, na? Because it is only one atom. Correct?
Yes, sir.
And then it doesn't make any sense that we have to predict the shape. For example, if you have two molecules. AB. What do you think? What will be the shape of AB? How can you make the bond? You can make bond like this only, na? AB. Somebody said, no, sir, I can make bond like this. A and B. What is the difference? Straight line only, na? Straight line only. The orientation is just changing. No difference. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So there is no ambiguity if you have one atom or if you have two atoms. But what about if you have three atoms? For example, you have AB2. Then the shape will be A. You can have like this. Or this is linear, right? 180 degree angle. You can also have A. There will be some B like this. There's some angle which is less than 180 degree. You can also have A and B, which is 90 degree. Correct. Now there are options. So we'll start from AB2. Okay. We'll start from where? AB2. Okay, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anna, all of you got it? Anna, we are also knowing why 1 and 2 are not there, only why we'll start with AB2. Now, if I say you have AB2, so this is the Lewis dot structure. I have shown each and every electron which is present, okay? Now tell me, what will be the steric number for this one? Don't write anything, but tell me what will be the steric number. Number of sigma bonds plus lone pair. Tell me, number of sigma bond is equal to? Number of sigma bond is 2 and lone pair?
0.
So steric number for this type of molecule is 2. Okay, so we'll start with steric number 2. चलिए अब आप लोग लिखना चालू कीजिएगा ठीक है अब आप लोग लिखना चालू कीजिए नंबर वन स्टेरिक नंबर टू स्टेरिक नंबर टू इफ यू हैव स्टेरिक नंबर टू देन द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज दैट यू विल हैव हाइब्रिडाइजेशन स्टेरिक नंबर टू आल्सो राइट सिग्मा इज इक्वल टू टू and lone pair is equal to 0. Hybridization for this will be always sp. Okay, one thing is very important, it will be always sp. Now we will look what is the sp hybridization. If the steric number is 2, the hybridization will be always sp. So in sp you will have one s orbital. Okay, and you will also have a p orbital. Oh my God, can you please appreciate the p orbital that I have made? Can you please appreciate that?
Sir, very nice.
Very nice, no? Very nice. This is S, this is P. This is like, I mean, I draw very good in blackboard and whiteboards. I mean, the reality one, not the virtual. This is the first time I have drawn very perfectly in the virtual whiteboard also. Okay. So if you have sp orbital, then what will happen? See, for example, if this is positive, then what will happen? These two will interact with each other. These two will interact with each other and they will enlarge. Okay, they will get enlarged like this. Now the pressure is on me to make all the p orbitals perfect. But it is not going to happen. Right? We have to accept this reality. That reality is often Marvel, Thanos, reality is often. So you guys have not seen. You have not seen the Marvel movies? Mariam, Samira, Safwan?
Sir, I don't remember.
You don't remember? There is a meme. The line. Reality is often disappointing. Do you remember now? You don't remember. Okay, fine. There is a meme also for that. Reality is often disappointing. Fair. So you will have sp. And how many will be there? This is sp. This is sp hybrid orbital. And there will be one more sp because the number of hybrid orbital is equal to the number of atomic orbital taking part in the hybridization. And one of the lobe will be getting enlarged. This is also sp. Now we have to put sp in space such that the repulsion is minimum. So obviously, the best option is to put them in 180 degree. I have a trick that I can use. I will get this. And I can just enlarge it. So.
Sir, this p orbital can also be drawn perpendicularly.
Perpendicularly? No, nah. I mean, you have to draw it like this only. Okay. You can draw it perpendicularly. There is no problem in that. Okay. There is no problem. Just for space reason, I have not drawn it perpendicularly. You can draw it perpendicularly also. This is positive. This is positive. Okay. And the angle here is 180 degree. So the points, atomic orbital which are taking part, is what s and p orbitals, and then what are the hybrid orbital that is getting up? We have two sp hybrid orbitals. Okay, there are two sp hybrid orbitals. Third point is the angle. angle is equal to what? Angle here is 180 degree. Okay. Because see, we have the lobes, right? These lobes should be in such a way that the distance between them is maximum and the repulsion is minimum. You cannot think of any other way other than 180 degree. Okay. Other than 180 degree. So write this down. Let me know if you're done.
Done, sir.
Done. Okay. Now, in this, we will also learn about the formation of beryllium fluoride. Now, in beryllium fluoride, can you tell me which of these elements will be taking part in, which will be having hybridization, beryllium or fluorine? Which will be hybridized, beryllium or fluorine? Atomic orbitals of beryllium or fluorine?
Fluorine.
Which is the central atom, beryllium or fluorine?
Beryllium.
Na? Fluorine and hydrogen can never be central atom, right? And also, yes, beryllium is less electronegative. That is why central, we have written na? Hybridization only of central atom, correct? We do the hybridization of central atom only. So please write, for beryllium, it is how much? Beryllium is atomic number 4. Please listen, okay? Please listen. The electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2. So we'll write the ground state electronic configuration. GS means ground state. So only one, that is 2s2. Now there will be 2p, because second shell mein 2p hota, this will be 0. So can I write it like this? There is 2p available, but this 2p has no electron. This is 2s and this is 2p. Now obviously, for bonding, do we need paired electrons or do we need singly occupied? We need one electron or two electron for pairing? One electron from each, right? One unpaired electron, right? Valence bond theory. One unpaired electron, correct? So what will happen? Promotion of electron. This is promotion. Promotion happens like this. The electron is promoted to the p orbital. Since it has to make how many bonds? Two bonds. That is why it needs two orbitals that are singly occupied. Two orbitals which are singly occupied. Now this s and this p, this is s and this is p, they will mix together and they will form hybrid orbital. Okay, they will form hybrid orbital. And this is, there will be two hybrid orbital. I have said set of hybrid orbital. Set means like this. Okay, that means these two have same energy. One electron here and one electron here. So the hybrid orbitals are what? This is sp hybrid orbital. This is also sp hybrid orbital. Now let us look at the beryllium structure. You have beryllium. And then you have, this is one of the sp. Let me make it. I'm just erasing the smaller parts, okay, which are not responsible for any bonding. This is the beryllium's hybrid orbitals. Beryllium's hybrid orbitals, and then this is phosphor, which has one electron. I'm putting it like this, okay. Just because I have to add fluorine also. So fluorine will also have p orbitals. I'm getting good at this. Really getting good at this. Another electron from fluorine and another electron from fluorine. Okay, this is for fluorine. Another fluorine, this is another fluorine. So this is the structure for BEF. So can you see that we have also taken care of valence bond theory? Overlapping bhi humne kara diya, and we also confirmed that it is having some sp orbitals. Okay, so these are the sp orbitals. This is sp. This is also sp. The name is sp. And this is the p orbital, and this is also the p orbital. This is also the p orbital. So the angle here is what? The angle here is what? 180 degree. So we can also draw it like this. Beryllium, fluorine, and fluorine. So here you will write geometry. Look at electron pair.
okay, and I will write which is linear. There is another thing which is not shape. Look at bonds. Okay, I will tell you what does these means. Look at bonds and look at electron pair. Where you have to look at them. Now you don't have to look because the electrons and the bonds are at the same place. Okay, but when lone pair will come, then you will have to look at electron and there the bond will not be present. So this is linear here also, and obviously the angle will be 180 degrees.
Done, sir.
All of you are done. Okay. The next you will write. So we are done with steric number two. Okay, we are done with steric number two. Right, steric number three. What did I write? Steric number three. Okay, steric number three. Now, if you have steric number three, that means you have number of sigma bond. Sigma is equal to three, and you have lone pair is equal to zero. Lone pair is equal to zero. Steric number three. Hybridization. Will be sp2. Hybridization will be sp2. Okay, so the atomic orbital that will be taking part will be 1s and 2p's, right? 1s and 2p's. So just let me borrow the s and p's from here. Reduce their size. So how many hybrid orbitals will be formed? Yes, guys. How many atomic orbitals are taking part in hybridization? How many EOs? How many atomic orbitals can you see? Tell me.
Three.
So how many hybrid orbitals will be formed? Three hybrid orbitals, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so three hybrid orbitals, all will be what? sp2. Now here also, one of the lobes will be enlarged. Okay, make it like this only. Talk a bit dramatic. This is one of them. Another. Okay, so there will be three hybrid orbitals, and all of them are what? These all are sp2. This is sp2. This is also sp2. And this is also sp2. Now tell me, how should I arrange it? You have 3 points, right? Okay, have you ever celebrated birthdays and something, and you have tied balloons? Have you tied balloons, Mariam?
Sir.
Achha. So you are tying three balloons, and think about the shape.
The small part will be in between. Means the right side will be in the middle.
Okay, let us say that these are the ends, okay? These are the ends of the balloon. So you have tied them. You have tied those three. And if you join these three ends, then what shape it will be there? What shape will be? It will be acquiring what shape?
Triangle,
right? It will be acquiring triangle, correct. Now, I hope all of you can see triangle. quite like this, correct?
Yes, sir.
And so these are the lobes only. These are the lobes only. Okay. These are the lobes. So let me just draw this. What do you think? What will be the angle between them? What do you think? What will be the angle between them?
Less than 180.
No, no, exactly. What I mean. You have three parts and 360, na? So 360 divided by 3. This will be equal to, I mean, they all will sum up to 360. 120, yeah, na? They all will sum up to 360 degrees. So it will be 120. Now, please remember, we are still on a plane. We are still on a plane. It will be 120 degrees. Okay. So if you have a point, you have one dimension. If you have a line, you have two dimensions. Now, if you have three points, then it makes a plane. Okay. You at least need three points to make a plane. Two points will make you a line. So we are still on 2D. Plane means 2D. Now, as soon as I will add the third one, okay, so these are the three. On top of them, I will add the third, fourth one. And then you can make a pyramid, right? You can make a pyramid like this, correct? Now, as soon as you will get to the fourth one, you will get to the three, you will not have 360 degree then, okay? You will not have 360 degree then. So 90 degree will not be the answer for 360. Just remember that. So here, let us write atomic orbitals. S, P, P. The hybrid orbitals. 3sp2. Hybrid orbitals. The angle. 120 degree. Angle will be 120 degree. Please write this down. Let me know if you're done.
Done, sir.
Right, formation of BCl3, formation of BCl3. Again, please make this habit. First of all, we will start with the, now please tell me what will be the central atom here, all of you.
B.
Boron, yeah, boron. Boron will be central atom. Boron is atomic number 5. We will see what are the electrons that will be taking part in the bond formation. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So we'll have the ground state first, the 2s electron, then we will have the 2p. So 2s is 2, then we have 2p. So how many bonds will the BCl3 making? It has to make how many bonds in BCl3? How many bonds in BCl3?
Three bonds,
but it has only one unpaired electron. So it has to do promotion, and then the excited state, we say excited or promoted state it is. In 2s you have one electron, and in the 2p you have two unpaired electrons. Now this s, this p, and this p, they all will mix together, and they will form the sp2 hybrid orbital. Okay, so sp2 is hybrid orbital. There will be three sp2s. One electron each. Okay, so also sp2. So sp2. This is also sp2. If you want the structure, it will be boron. It will be having these. These are what? sp2. This is also sp2. This is also sp2. This is also sp2. And the chlorine will be bonding like this. Okay, so these are chlorine. This is also for chlorine. And these are the p orbitals. Okay, so you have one electron here. The shape that you will acquire is B, chlorine, and chlorine. So here also, as we see that the geometry and the shape, they will be same, because where the bonds and the electron, they are at the same place. Okay, see, where are the bonds? Bonds are here, this way. Bonds are here also. These are the bonds. Okay, these are the bonds. So all the bonds and electrons, they are on the same place. That is why the geometry and the shape, they will be same. So please write geometry. Geometry is trigonal planar. I don't have space now. I'm just getting a bit down, okay? Geometry is trigonal planar. The shape will be trigonal planar. The bond angle